Hello and welcome, everybody. This is Fantastic. I'm doing fantastic. So, the Chaos update came out. Major content update. It's pretty good. Not as much as I was expecting, but hey, it did bring good swag right now. Did bring us into the newest trinkets. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We have the new trinkets or the keepsakes. So let's get right into the 17 now. They have added one, and let us get straight into it and see which is the worst and then to the best. Though it's very similar to the last one, however, there is some slight changes now. So let's just talk about changes between levels now. So each and every single keepsake now has a level towards it. So, for example, I have my skull earring at level or rank 2. So that gives from 120% damage goes now to 123% damage. So it's just a little bit stronger. So, it's pretty useful. So just clear 25 encounters for rank 1, and after that is 75 encounters to rank 3, and then I'd probably say it goes on until whenever the rank stops. So, let's get straight into the keepsakes and what they really. Let me tell you now. Okay, so, worst trinket, and I just have to put it in the Adamant Arrowhead. Now, these trinkets and keepsakes are compared on the boon that you can get with the keepsake. So it's not about really how the blessing is extra plus 10% and rare or better for an Artemis. I mean, Artemis is fucking, she's fucking thick. She's pretty good now. They changed the picture. But Artemis's Adamant Arrowhead is the worst. She has the worst boons and it's just not as useful. And that's just facts. So, Adamant Arrowhead is the worst from Artemis. Then the second worst would have to be the conch shell from Poseidon. As again, I'm not going to go into much detail, but this is all about the boons. The boons are just not as useful, there's not much flexibility, and yeah, the conch shell is just not that good. Now, each of these, except for one that you'll see in a bit, has the benefit of plus 10% chance to be a rare or better boon. It also is a hidden mechanic apparently where it's an increased chance, as well as on top of the next boon you will find will be from Poseidon. So there's even more chances with these keepsakes equipped. Which, remember, you can only have one keepsake equipped at a time. But the second worst would be the conch shell. Third worst would be the black shoal. Now, what the fuck? They fucking changed it, cunt. So the third worst would then be the. And I hate to say it, it would have to be the blood-filled vial. And it's just there's more properties like the damage over time, but other than that, it is not very much utility in towards the boons for Ares. Then going on to the fourth worst, it would have to be Zeus's Thunder Signet. Zeus is very useful, and that cannot be denied, but he's just not as good in utility. The only good thing is probably his revenge damage, which is high impact lightning towards an enemy that hit you, or if the enemy has died, then it will attack another enemy. Other than that, chain lightning is not useful in this content patch. Okay, going to the fifth worst, it would have to be, and it is The Eternal Rose from Aphrodite. There's some new boons, and it has really useful as well, on top of making enemies weak, which is a debuff that really helps take less damage. There's also a buff now where you just take reduced damage overall just from the Eternal Rose boon from Aphrodite. So Eternal Rose is definitely up there. But the sixth worst, moving on now, would be the Owl Pendant. Now, if you can get the Titan Toppler boon, you win the game. You straight up win this game. I'm telling you, it's so good. The Titan Toppler deflects everything, and Athena's has high damage deflect buffs and everything, and it is really useful just getting an Athena. Like, be it normal or the common variety, the rare variety, or the epic variety, the Owl Pendant is super useful. Now, moving on to the seventh worst keepsake, it would have to be, and now this is better than these six, definitely, and it is the newest keepsake to be introduced into the game, and that would be the Cosmic Egg. So you can enter Blood Gates without losing health. Blessings from Chaos have 20% chance to be rare or better. So that's a plus 10% chance to be better. And you don't take any damage from Blood Gates anymore. And that's useful because Chaos is a very strong character that can help your run go so smooth. So Chaos has this thing, the Primordial Chaos, the character that was being newly introduced, has a thing where you can get Death Defiance. Now, for about 2 to 3 turns, sometimes 4 turns, depending on if it's an epic variant, you can gain buffs, permanent buffs to your cast, your damage output, and the how much coin and darkness you earn, and as well as a Death Defiance. So you can just keep going as long as there's a blood gate, as long as you can spawn one in from the shop, you can just keep going, get this boon, and that's it. And that's it. If you get a lucky run, and there's a lot of blood gates now, so it's, you don't even have to be lucky. You can get so many Death Defiances or permanent just overall bonuses. So that's why this is the best keepsake for the gods. These seven are the god keepsakes that help you with boons, and Cosmic Egg is definitely up there. Now, moving on to the eighth keepsake, and it would have to be the Harpy Feather Duster from Dusa. I haven't seen Dusa around recently, but broken urns only have 2% chance to contain healing items. I think even if you ranked it up, it's not really worth it. But as you can obviously know, it's just not that useful. It's still more useful than the boons, to be honest, because I just feel like it is. As long as you can get healing items, where if these boons are just they're okay. But I must mention though, the reason why I put the boons so low for keepsake is that because you can get the God's Pride or the other one in the skill tree, which, you know, helps with the getting the rare or epic variant. And it's just so much more useful. Unless you really want to spawn in this god, but trust me, you're going to see every single god if you can get a good run. You can get to through the Tartarus and Asphodel, you're going to see pretty much every single god that's useful. So, moving on, we're going down to the Bone Hourglass. So, this is the ninth worst keepsake. So, items from World Carrion have durations increased by 2 encounters. Self-explanatory. It's not that. It's not that better. It's better than this, and it's definitely better than all these. Nah, so I might sound a little biased, but you have to trust me on this. I've played this game so much, and this can be useful in certain situations. Because if you break, we'll come back to the harpy feathers. If you go back, there's so many pots, so you're bound to get a healing item, and it is a strong healing item, by the way. But anyway, moving on to the 10th worst trinket within the game, and it would have to be, and I'm kind of have to say this, the Miri Midon Bracer. Take 15% less damage from the front, but 10% more from the back. It's pretty self-explanatory. You're gonna take a lot of damage to the front, not much damage from the back. But yeah, and this is from Achilles. Then the 11th worst trinket in the game would have to be Black Shoal. Black Shoal is used for resource gathering, really, and it's for the darkness and health. It's 20% extra of the amount, whatever you have, and it has its uses because leveling up quicker and health really does a lot. But it is good, just not as good as people imagine. So then, going further into it, to the 12th keepsake on the list, it would have to be Distant Memory. Distant Memory is from Orpheus. Bow to bows. So using the bows can be is much more viable now because it's stronger. And 100%, 110% damage to distant foes. Distant foes don't have to be too distant in order to get that damage buff up. So definitely is the 12th. Now towards the 13th, it would have to be the Chthonic Coin Purse. This is from Hypnos. Automatically saves up 100 what you had when you last died. Not all the time you're gonna have 100, but whatever you have in store, there you go. You can have that little extra back, and it can really help. Even though right now you can just have four, you can have as many coins from the skill tree, which I'll show you at the end, which you can just get as many coins as you want. I think it's about 60 coins, and it's really not, coins aren't really that useful unless you're going for decoration items or you're in really in a bind, but you should have more than enough by breaking the urns and everything. But you know, it's still viable. And then moving on to the 14th trinket, it would have to be, and it is from Sisyphus, the rubble falling from damaged pillars deals 300% damage to your foes. That's really good. That's top notch. That's what you want. And if you can really get enemies in the corner, and there's a lot more destructive items now, you're pretty much guaranteed to one-shot the weak enemies. It's self-explanatory. Then the 16th is the Old Spike Collar. Now, people might be like, not really. Personally, the Old Spike Collar, you have plus 20 health more than usual. That can really help with early runs. Early runs, Old Spike Collar is a must-have. Yeah, just you have to have it to really support yourself to get more and more, and keep pushing yourself through and through. And yeah, it's really, really good. Now, of course, ranking up, you're gonna get more health. So the more you do, the more viable the method of using this keepsake is. Now, to the 16th trink keepsake is the Lucky Tooth. When you take lethal damage, stay alive with 15 health once. So it's pretty much a extra death defiance. Meaning that if you can get a lucky run, you can get about 7 death defiances. You can get the 3 from the mirror, which is your skill. From your skills, you can get at least 3 with a good to moderate to good run from Chaos plus the Lucky Tooth. There you go. That's about 7 death defiances if you go for that route. By the way, surviving a lethal damage and having health afterwards, extremely useful. And this from Skelly. Then the best, and will pretty much always remain the best, is the Skull Earring from Meg. It deals 120% damage, I believe, at base, while at 40% health or lower. So this was, before it was 200% damage at like 20%, and they lowered it, but still, I feel like kind of a buff, as well as a debuff, because having a lower health percentage means you can just, because your survivability just goes up. So yeah, 80% damage less is bad, but 120% damage on top of any of your other boons, that's super good. And just having overall damage to one shot, like pretty much all the weak enemies, and then 2 to 3 shotting the big enemies, super useful. Plus ranking up gets more damage. For example, rank 2 here, 123% damage. That's gonna really one shot a lot of the early on and smaller enemies. And that's the list. All 17 keepsakes in my opinion, towards what's best. What's worst to best. Now, let me show you the viability of the Chthonic Coin Purse and the skills. So, deep pockets, I can have 80 coins. Don't know why it's not showing at the lower right, but that's 80 coins. Plus, you can get either the Olympian Favor, which is as a 1% bonus for a boon, to have a rare effect, which is just 50 50 50, and you're gonna get that chance. So, which you could just have with a keepsake, or if you just save up, which you're gonna have a lot spare either way, you can just put into there. Or you can go the route, which is the better route, is the God's Pride. That's one plus 1% chance of having an epic, and let me tell you now, I get epic a lot. The variety comes quite a lot. But anyway, that was the list. This was the comparison of towards it. And this is brand new. Man, opinionated, very opinionated. And that's how I just run my game. But anyway, thanks for watching. Please comment and subscribe. Subscribing is free. Please. Please. And put a like down below if you like the video. And comment if you have any questions. Alright. Catch ya.